Hello and welcome, one and all. We are here today for round one of the FS1 series here at simleague.de, the main Premier League, and this is our first year of broadcasting, so it's all new, all exciting times for the league here at the moment, as we're doing our first season of broadcast and the first season of private teams as well, privately owned teams and teams made by others to be entered into the series. So exciting times here. We're just ending warm up now. Probably going to race very, very soon. And it's going to be an interesting time. You've got guys on pace here. We've got some quite close battles. Everyone, especially in the top half of the field, very close in pace. So should be a lot of fun. And joining me here today, doing the cameras and the co-commentary, so doing the old double duty here, is Mr. Quinton Plain. Say hello.
Hello there. It's great to be here this evening.
Indeed, it is, and it's going to be quite something else this race, I think, with with the pace of some. Sandeep Chhoda has been showing good pace. He qualified on pole here for the race, with Sam Howell right behind him, and not too much between the two, only a few tenths. So it's really going to be quite close, this battle for the lead. And as I said, everyone in the midfield very, very similar pace. But yeah, it's very, very, very exciting stuff. As I've had a couple of guys here having a few little issues trying to get connected and make sure that their games are good. But they're connected now, so hopefully.
Attention, Lord, we're all non-essential personnel. Leave the world now.
There's our favourite announcer man just announcing that we are indeed have gone to race here. We'll introduce everything else as once the race gets underway. As oops, someone's just crashed right as we go to race. So it looks like he's not going to make it. But we are not far off going green here. Here it's our round one at Melbourne of the FS1 series. And on pole should be Mr. Sandeep Chhoda. He's on pole after a really fantastic lap, beating Sam Howell there. So he's on pole there, Sandeep, followed by Sam Howell. He's got Theodoros Isaroglu in third. Sorry, I'm trying my best here to pronounce the name. Sorry if I get them wrong. Owen Golding is four. Nikos and Anastasopoulos is fifth. Dimitar Vuk is sixth. Kalyn Sirkev is seventh. Andrew Summel, eighth. Michael Baldessarra is ninth. Sovios Van Sis rounds the top 10 for BRM. And it's Todi Mitsalis, also for BRM. So they're look at that row right there, the fifth row or fifth or sixth row, I believe it is, in 10th, 11th. That's Susie Bolt-Lucas for 12th, very first up, and Tamas Varkasis, also for FSR, so 12th, 13th. A lot of teammates being kept here, very strange. Then it's Joel Piera is 14th, Mark Theorx is 15th. Oh, although he's spinning around on the warm-up lap, hopefully he can catch up and get back onto the pack. And you got David Vane is 16th. Eric Strahan is 17th. But no, that's not right. I think there's some kind of a problem there with the lineup. And I do notice we're missing a few guys. And also one of the men in there is, what does it cost us? Dezapos is there apparently in 20th, but I'm pretty sure it's not right because I know that I'm not supposed to be in front of him. So, a couple of issues here, a few people crashing and so on. But I guess that is how it's gone. But that is your field as I see it anyway, lined up. They're all just finishing their warm-up lap. But I was quickly asked before we start, Quinton, who's your pick for this race?
It's got to be between the top three. You can only really win in Melbourne from the first two rows. So we're going to see a big battle. We're going to see Sandeep and Sam renewing their battle from last season. And maybe even Theo might get in there, having found some pace over the winter. So I can't say who's going to win, but one of the top three, that's my prediction.
All right, well there you go. So we're just waiting on Mark to catch up here. I think he had a few spins on warm-up lap, so he's just coming around the final corner. In fact, he's pitting, which is interesting. So is he might not even race, which is awkward. But let's have a look. He's going to pit lane unless he's staying with the pit lane, which is also possible. Not entirely sure.
Damage on his back.
Yeah. I see the steering's bent, so he's got some suspension damage. But we are away anyways. Lights are going out while I was looking there. Sandy's got away in a nice start, but Sam's got an even better one. He's actually in the lead down in turn one. Takes to the inside, but oh, Sandy holds it. Nice. Ran the outside. Very, very nice from the Adonis driver. And Sam's got second, but Golding's all over the back of him here as they go down the straights. Insignia versus T4. As oh, no, Sam's been hit. He's off. Oh, drama. Owen, he's just tagged him as he's going to the corner, and round he goes. So drama at the start. Sandy's been given a little bit of a free pass now. Look at this gap he's got back to Theodorus there. So unbelievable stuff to start the race. And he's already got 1.5 seconds, so just unbelievable. Andrew Sommerlead just bounces off the curve back and forth. Oh, and the contact with Michael, and oh, how did they not go around? That is insane. So just controversy starts. Oh, hello, someone's gone off in the background. That is Kostas has gone off. He's gone round back in ninth. But oh, everyone seems to have managed to avoid him. So drama's. Oh, as Joel Piera is off or is out with the. He doesn't even have a rear wing down in 18th. Dimir Vuk is out with an accident apparently as well. So we've got drama here at the start of the race. Unbelievable stuff. But what do you think of that there, Quinton? That was quite the start.
Well, I noticed straight off the line, many people struggled to. It's the first start of the race season, so people were. We saw a lot of crashes on the start finish straight, so it was a bit shocking. But everyone, it's the first race, as I say, so everyone's going to be a bit rusty. So now they're going to settle all into the race, and hopefully we'll see some better driving now.
Yeah, indeed. That was definitely not the cleanest of starts, but such is the way of things. You get that. It is the first race of the season. You've got to keep that in mind, so we're all sort of trying to get used to the cars, but Sandy bleeds. Theodorus is hanging on, though. He's actually kind of half catching him here in this early stage. Something else to note as... Oh, hello. Oh, we got someone round. That's Summel. He's round from, I believe, he's in third or fourth. So he continues on, though. It doesn't look like he's going to get damaged, so he'll be fine. But Sam Howell, by the way, down in 10th now for Tafra. Starting second, so he'll be charging through the field. We know he's got the pace, so we'll keep an eye on that for you. But drama starts here for the first round here of this new season. Really quite an interesting start. I'm so caught up with everything happening. I almost missed it there because of people having to start from pit lane as Golding now is going round the outside of Baldessari here. As Summel's getting involved too, we have a three-way battle here down towards the S. Summel's going to go try to go around the outside here, and that is a brave move. He actually makes it stick before we get to the S, so he's through. But Baldessari is holding on for the moment in 7th. This is down at, sorry, I should probably mention the position earlier. He's down for 7th. Summel, though, is under attack again here. Counter-attack coming from Owen. Will he try around the outside? No, he's going to try and flick it back and go to the inside, and he gets it done. So nice move there. Good stuff there from Owen. Sam is just seeing behind here and all this, just sort of being patient, which is probably a good call. We don't want to crash out here in this early stage. As they're all fighting for 7th, and that's probably your closest battle right now. Sandeep still leads, got about... He's probably got about, yeah, 1.5 seconds in the lead right now. They've also had Kostas retired with suspension damage, apparently, so that's another retirement. So 15 left out of the 19 starters, so very high attrition rate here at this early stage. Just looking through, still think that bell for 7th is still your best one. There's Owen now going around the outside, and he gets it done on Baldessaro. Also, where's Sam gone? Oh, okay, Sam's pitted. Interesting, so I wonder if that was for damage. But, oh no, Owen's around! Oh, he's around there just before end of Sector 1. As he goes around the wall, I wonder if he's got any damage. You would assume so. These cars aren't amazingly tough. Owen's gone around. Continues on, but he's locked down off the back of that battle for 7th. Now Summel versus Baldessaro, and they're coming up on a lap car as well, which is Nico's there. He's a lap car for Everest GP. I believe he had some damage, so he's going to be just in front of these guys as they battle it out. But it's all very interesting, isn't it? It's been quite a drama to start for this one, hasn't it?
Exactly. It's the start of the season, everyone's going to be rusty, but I'm surprised that some people haven't settled down into racing. I'm surprised that some people are taking quite early pit stops. Sam Howe just been into the pits on lap 3, so we'll have to find out later on why he did this. It's a bit surprising, maybe he had got damage earlier on because he did have the contact with Aaron Golding on the, down at turn three on the first lap. So we don't know why he's pitted, but hopefully we'll see him back up there.
Indeed, as it's about for third now, this has been Kalyn Sirkev and Stelios Vansis. They're going at it for third, and then you've also got Lucas and Mitsalis not far behind them. So this is probably one of your closer battles, as the top two are just going off down the road. They're now 10 seconds clear, the top two, the rest of the field, so they're kind of in a league of their own at this point. But this third place battle is relatively close, although Sirkev's just opened it up slightly here. But they're all sort of coming together. There might be a close four-way battle that might eventually develop by the looks of how they're closing up. They're, probably your closest real battle. Everyone's just sort of settling down now after that initial, the initial debacles there. They're all sort of settling down now into the rhythms. But an interesting start this was the season, as we've also had another retirement. Golding's gone. Suspension damage, so obviously the damage was too much, and he's now out of the race, so another retirement. We've had four gone in the first three laps. We're only 8% through, so high attrition rate here, but it is Melbourne. It's quite an unforgiving circuit, so you really do have to be very careful around here to keep it on track.
But, actually lost it out coming out of turn five, the high-speed right-hander. He just took too much pace in. Didn't take enough of the apex and got spun around as he hit the outside wall. So that damage, I saw that he tried to get it back to the pits and repaired, but probably his pit crew was too much damage for them to repair in one pit stop. So he's out of the first race.
It's a shame, isn't it? A bad start for him, especially as he had pace for definitely a top five at the very least. As just looking at Eric Stanford going around the outside of David Vane, 10th into turn one, so he makes a move up. Sam Howell's just caught up to that too, so you'd assume he should make that pass as well. What I'm finding interesting is how many people are on the medium. There's actually a lot of people on the medium compound, not many on the super soft, which I find interesting. Usually you'd start on the fastest tyre, but it seems everyone wants to get the long run out of the way first, which is interesting to see. But just an observation I noticed is, just going back to the leads, Chiroj is still leading, by the way, quite easily at the moment. It's 3.4. I'm back to Theodorus, who is, he's hanging on, but he's not really catching. He's just been slowly but surely dropping back. And it's now, it's about 12 seconds back to third, which is now Stelios. He's gotten around Sirkev, who made a mistake there, and he's now under the pump from Lucas and Mitsalis. They're together now. That's the battle fourth at this point. But Sirkev's got a good pace, so you would assume he should be able to pull back away if he can just keep it consistent. Although Metzalis has got a very nice exit. He might have a look down to turn one here. He'd be brave if he does, but no, he's got the Lucas got the slipstream of Sirkev, so he'll be able to hold on there. Fourth, fifth spot as Baldessaro, by the way, back under pressure from Sommel. Sommel goes down the inside. Has he gone too deep? He has. Baldessaro gets it back, and that's a lap car, sorry. That's not for position there. Sommel gets taken by the lap car. But, I hope he doesn't get in the way there. Sommel goes back down the inside and relaps him, but dumb attempts there from Sommel, but not quite able to get it done. It's quite a gap actually back to Stanford as everyone else is being out a bit, but probably really that battle for fourth is really your closest one at the moment. But interesting starts, I must say. But what are we looking at, do you think, pit strategy wise here, Quentin?
The medium tyre, I've been hearing reports that it's quite a good tyre to be on at the moment. It's got plenty of grip and the durability is there. The super softs, the reason why I don't think anyone's running the super softs is because you're going to wear up the front left so much around this track being a clockwise circuit. And the front left really gets overheated on these really high speed corners, so people are probably trying to get onto the medium tyre as soon as possible, because they're lasting 15 laps, I've heard, and while the super softs are completely gone off a cliff by the end of an eight lap stint.
Well, there you go, that sort of explains the strategies here of everybody, why they're doing the medium. And also, of course, with fuel, I'd suspect that maybe a lot of people want to do the medium while it's on full load, so that because it'll obviously, as you said, it won't overheat as much, whereas a super soft, of course, overheats, it won't handle the full load as much or as well. As Lucas, by the way, just went wide there, I just noticed he's dropped back a bit off the back of Mitsalis. But it's also spread out a little bit now already. Everyone's just getting into their rhythms. I'm noticing the times, though. Sandeep is just pretty much doing high 30s consistently. It's amazing how consistent he's being right now. Whereas Theodorus is mostly managing low 31s. So Sandeep just really pulling away now. It's 5.3 seconds now. And then it's about another 7 back to 3rd. And another about 5 back to Sir Kevin. There's a little sort of mini pack all in. Oh, it's hello. Samuel and Baldassare are going at it again into the S's. This is over 7th. So they're still going at it, these two, having a right old scrap, these guys. As, ooh, geez, someone goes wide there, just going over the curbing, but he manages to get away with it. Tamas, by the way, in the other FSR car, is catching up to these two as they battle away. So keep an eye on him to maybe make this a three-way. As Lucas, as I said, is just in front of them. And they are sort of seeming to catch Lucas here. It's possibly tyres maybe going off. As you said, they go off that cliff at about lap 8, and we're about 7 in. So it's getting to the end of that window. Super soft. Baldassare pits 7th on the medium, which is interesting. That's a very short stint on a medium tyre. So not sure if maybe he's having a especially bad tyre or something's going on there, but it's an interesting little development as you go around. But that's something else. I didn't think he'd pit that early on the medium, but circumstances permitted, I guess.
Could well be that he's going to stretch out this middle stint and then go for the super softs when the track temperature has cooled down a little bit, and then and all the fuels burn off, so he can have that ultimate pace right at the end.
Yeah, indeed, well, that's very true. There might be a bit of a strategy in at play, as Sam Howe is still in 10th, by the way, so he's not really made much progress in this early stage. Just kind of hanging off the back of Stanford. Stanford seemed to have pretty good pace. We have mentioned how he has shown good pace before. He's showing it here. He's managed to keep Sam at bay, and it's back at 9th and 10th now, actually, thanks to Baldassare pitting. But interesting times here, as I'm just looking through the field. That's really the closest battle now, that one for 10th between those two. Sam, of course, trying to come through the field after the spin at the start with contact with Golding. So, bit of a drama start that was that first lap. Everyone just struggling to get used to the starts of these cars, and then a few crashes and spins. Of course, we had a few issues with people, just having issues technically, which is why we've just got a few people who haven't been able to race here. They've just had problems. As Eric Stanford going defensive here, Sam will probably go down the inside into... That's a risky move. He's going to get done. Yep, Stanford gives in the room. So Sam then moves up to 9th. And he's charged through. Oh, Stanford's counter-attacking there. That's a nice move. I think it's down to turn 14 there. Nice move. But now Sam will have a good exit down to turn 1. Of course, DRS and Kurz, of course, in this series are available. So interesting to see if he's maybe going to use them to get past. There he goes. Flicks left. Oh, right, sorry. Stanford pulls out there. There he goes. He managed to defend. Good defense there from Stanford. But Sam having to really push hard here to try and get him. Possibly thinking maybe Sam's looking down the inside here. He might actually be able to get it done. And yep, gets it done. And good stuff there. Gets the move done up to 9th. 8th, sorry, as I think another one was pitting. That was Sommel now, who's pitted, and he's come out again on the super soft, so going a double super soft for Sommel. Yeah, interesting, I didn't notice no DRS or Kurz look to be open for Sam, so maybe he's doesn't have a DRS and Kurz or working, which could be interesting, make things a bit harder for him to pass people, but there you go.
I think it's because the detection zone is just before the penultimate corner, and that's when he was just ahead of Stanford. Before Stanford made the lunge down inside the hairpin. So
yes,
technically Stanford would have got the DRS, but he didn't open it.
Good pick up. I actually forgot about that little bit, that the DRS zone is that far forward. It's back at sort of about where they're passing now, is roughly where the detection zone is. So Sam should have DRS here for this, for a counter-attack, maybe. So keep an eye on that, as Baldassare seems to be sort of catching up to them as they're sort of battling away. I'll just keep an eye on if Stanford counter-attacks here. They go onto the final corner, having a look. Doesn't look like these DRS is open, but that might just be that I can't see it. Which possibly actually has it open, but he doesn't seem to really gain there, so it's possible he didn't put it open. Maybe he hasn't got it working, or some kind of issue there which could explain that. But he's still over the... Oh, sorry, you go.
He does Stanford does have a lot of issues with the DRS and KERS, so he's actually at a disadvantage not running it at most tracks. Here it's not going to affect him as greatly, but still losing 6.6 seconds of an extra 80 horsepower.
Yeah, indeed. So it's not a huge amount, but it does definitely have an effect as everyone's just coming through now. As I said, Summel, another pit stopper there. That's why he dropped down behind them, doing his stop. But none of the leaders pitting yet. Sandeep's still going around. Get to pit is now 6.3 seconds, by the way. He's the lead, just goes past Thurux there, who's down 13th. Now goes a lap down. He's still going around, so his pace is not as up to the par as a lot of the guys at the top, but he is still going, so that's all he needs to do. If he can just survive, he'll probably do well there, because this is quite a high attrition track. But Theodorus is still second. He's 6.1 down. He's just been slowly losing time as we've been going along. It's about another 10 back to Vansis there for BRM. Then it's Sirkev for GBR Racing. He's in fourth. And then it's, I believe, the two FSRs, as though one of them is pitting. That's Lucas now. He's just pitting for FSR. We'll just see what Tari goes on to. Looks like the medium. So yeah, looks like double medium for him. As pit stops are becoming a thing now. Stanford coming as well from the Super Soft. Good sniff from him, by the way. 9 laps on the Super Soft. That's quite a nice stint, as you were saying. 8 laps seems to be that sort of cliff, and he's taken it to 9. So good stuff for Stanford on that first stint. Nice and long. He goes on the medium now for the second stint.
Stanford did actually have a spin coming out of a high-speed chicane, so his tyres, he probably flat-spotted them, so he needed to come in at the end of that lap.
Yeah, indeed. And I mean, it was probably in close to his window anyway, as you said. If it's 8 laps on a stint of them, he would have been close to the end of his stint regardless. So probably good timing in the end, as he comes in now and out in 11th. So you can see where Sam comes out in comparison to him when he pits. But everyone, as I said, a bit spread at the moment. All just sort of in their own little areas. Sandeep's still leading 6.4 now. He's been slowly opening that gap, and it continues to be like that as he goes along. He's been dominating so far. Good to mention that Menno Collins, his teammate, good pace, definitely in top 10 sort of pace for sure, possibly even better. But he just having issues with the game crashing. As I said, a few people having technical issues, which unfortunate, but does happen, unfortunately. Tamas just pitting there for a facade. Again, on the Super Soft, 10 laps, another good stint for him. A nice long stint in those tyres, and he goes to the medium as well. So he just pitting and just exiting now. Gets a bit of wheel spin there as he exits pit lane. Probably going to come out right about his teammate, or just ahead, actually. Yeah, just ahead, as we've just had a retirement. David Vane for Everest just retiring there in 13th. So it's another retirement from suspension damage. That puts his teammate up one now to 13th. So he's the last... will be anyway, the last driver still going here. So, again, high attrition range, as we said. It is just Melbourne. It's quite an unforgiving track, and it's showing here in these early stages. Just looking through. Theodore is still dropping back. It's now 8 seconds. Let me have a look at the times. Yes, he's doing low 31s. His last low was a high 31. But as I said, Sandeep, just 30s, 30s. He did do a couple of 31s last lap, so that could be from tyre wear and or traffic, as Stelios just pits for BRM now from third. So he'll probably come out round about his teammate, actually. He'll probably come out round about Mitsalis, so that's interesting to see. He's been at 32% apparently through this race, but interesting start of the season, I must say. What are your thoughts on it so far?
Well, it's been a bit of dirty driving. People crashing into each other and people running. There's a lot of people running wide, which I'm surprised about. Perhaps they need to perhaps slow it down a bit and then get the consistent driving and then work on their pace. But ultimately, it's looking like it's going to be a good season. All the drivers, lots and good quick drivers. Sandeep isn't running away with it as we expected him to. I mean, Theo is within 8 seconds. He's losing time to him, but he's still within 8 seconds. He can easily get that back over the other 60% of the race left. So I'm impressed by a lot of the drivers.
Indeed, Speaker Sandy is pitting now. So he's coming in for his first stop. It's 12 laps on the medium. Again, right as we said, it's about the time frame. Looking at his Theodore is going to keep on. So he's going to try and stretch that medium out. But there you go, Sandy Ben. We'd assume by that sort of stop, you go 12, 24. And you may have to go prime, medium, medium, then double soft potentially to get to the end. Obviously, having to use each set of tyres throughout the race when it's a dry race. So he may have to do a double stint for super softs at the end, but it is quite high tyre wear here, quite a high tyre wear track around Melbourne. As he's now dropped down to seconds, so Theodorus is going to lead here for at least some amount of time, so at least that's something he can say. There's a battle for third, by the way. Sirkev's under pressure from Stelios here. Of course, he's just pitted, so he'll have fresh pace, fresh rubber. It's probably why he's all over the back of Sirkev here, and Sirkev going defensive. Oh, Vance is nearly going around outside, makes a mistake. And his teammate catching up too in all of this, which is quite nice for him. We've had someone off. Who is that? See tyre smoke everywhere. That was Nikos there down 13th for Everest, just going around. He's lost his front wing, so he's going to limp it around a pit lane. So, not a good start for Everest for the season. One retirement and one struggling at the back end of the field. But that battle for third still going. Sirkev still holds on for the time being. For GBR Racing, having a decent start here, 3rd and 11th they are at the moment, and then a good start. As I said, and Adonis really would probably be the ones who'd be having the best start, but Menno of course having those technical issues, so not able to participate here, which is a real shame for him. But Theodore is now coming in out of the lead, so it gifts the lead to Sandy, as he pits now with the medium. Probably going to go to medium again, honestly. We'll just have a look. And yep, just stays in the mediums. He's going to do another medium stint just like Sandy. Sirkev still defending here. He's defending heavily from Stelios. He didn't want to pit there because the inside was blocked. He doesn't. So now Vance gets past now for that 7th place. But there's easily could be a counterattack here as they go down the straight. Sirkev's looking very feisty, but he's not going to have a look. So holds on there. He's in a nice little BRM sandwich there. So now Mitsalis is looking quite keen to get back at him on the super soft. And I wonder if he'll have a look down the inside. Here he's looking. So it gives the room, and down the inside he goes. Will he go for the switchback? Oh, he goes wide, and quite deep there, Mitsalis. Very deep, so it's going to drop him off the back now. And maybe even put him in the clutches of Sam Howe, who's still coming through the field. He's now 6th, so he is making a charge, and it is working so far.
However, he's coming to the end. He pitted on lap 3, I believe, so it's part of getting nearer the end of their life.
Yeah, indeed. So he'll probably pit in the next few laps, you would assume. As everyone's spread out, unfortunately, there's not really any battles going on. Everyone's quite spread. We did find this at Bahrain, for those of you who watched that pre-season race. The same kind of thing happened. It was got quite spread after the initial sort of 10 laps or so. Quite spread out. And it's happening again here. Everyone just in their own little areas. No one really having any feisty battles, unfortunately. Maybe it's just Mitsalis and Sirkev, you're probably closest. Though Sam is closing at quite the rate. Again, we know he is fast, very fast, so he's got the pace to be up there, definitely in second at least, but that is quite a gap he's got to gain in. Of course, as you said, he's still got a pit again, so he might drop, he's probably going to drop way down to, you'd assume, sort of, probably 8th again after he pits behind someone. He just pits now, so there we go, picked it right, and Sirkev coming in 2 for GBR, so both of them coming in at the same time. We'll see what they do, probably both go medium, would be my guess. Sam stays in the medium, and Sirkev going in the super soft, so he's going to get that one out of the way now in this middle stint, and Sam actually jumps him in pit lane, so I reckon Sirkev there having a little bit of damage maybe attended to as well. It's actually dropping him back a long way. It's quite a long stop, so he now exits. He's going to lose quite a bit of time from that, but Sam comes out 7th, and now he actually gains a spot thanks to Sirkev being quite slow in the stops. Actually, Lucas there might have a chance at Sirkev as they're going to turn 1. He's on the super soft circuit, but he's just come out of pit lane. So cold tyres. Let's have a look. He's held, it seems. So he's going to hold on to that a 9th spot. Said long stops. Obviously had a little bit of damage to repair there. So, but he's continuing on now. So good for him in 9th. And that's another stop done. And so let's do a quick, just while we have a time of everyone just sort of in their own worlds. What do you reckon is your favourite livery? The guys so far.
Favorite livery? That is a very difficult question. There's so much. We've got 8 private teams and then another 4 admin run teams. Though, to be fair, one of them is currently negotiations are ongoing to be brought. I'll say that much. I'm not going to say who it is, but expect Tuesday there will probably be an announcement. But back to your question about liveries, I would probably say the FSR team. They have got a very nice looking car. What? Who else? GBR too, who we're looking at now. They've got quite a nice car, but that's actually been designed by one of the admins, because a lot of the cars or teams, Tamas pretty much did half of the field, I believe. So Tamas gets a vote from me, but as does the admins for their livery work.
Indeed. Yeah, I would have to agree. FSR's is a very, very pretty livery, I must say. And yeah, I will agree. GBR's, especially considering that was one of the admin teams. It's not one of the privately owned ones. It's quite a good-looking skin, considering it is an admin team. So very good stuff there. As also Summel, by the way, is having a crack at Baldessaro for fifth. He's on the super soft Summel, so he's got the pace over Baldessaro. You'd assume he should be able to get past, seeing he's got this pace on him. There's a little flick there, there's a little bit of a look, but, it seems to work, because Baldessaro goes wide, so that little flick there seemed to do the job. Ooh, has a look, but not going to do it there. It's a difficult spot to overtake. You really have to both commit to going side by side through there. Baldessaro pits there, that was roughly about the end of his window, as we see. He did pit early, so I do sense maybe a bit of an alternative strategy going on there. As he pits now from 5th, he'll drop down probably to around about 8th or 9th, as also, Therux is in as well from the back end field in 12th on the medium, and Baldessaro going back on the medium as well. So he's still yet to do the soft, I believe, so he'll probably do that again at the end of the race, like Sandeep and Theodorus are doing. Sandeep, by the way, still cruising at the moment out in the lead. He's 15.3 seconds clear, so he started to really gap him. Gap Theodorus, because I think he had a couple of bad laps there just after and before he stopped. So whereas Sandeep's pretty much been consistent 29s here for this ever since the stop, really. So amazing pace here from Sandeep. A good couple of seconds a lap faster than Theodorus, or a good second at least a lap faster than Theodorus there, which is why he's pulling away in the lead. And it's quite a gap back to Vansis.
Crash.
Oh, where are we looking?
Down in 10th position.
Ooh, Baldessaro, he's out. Oh no, it's terrible for him. He's having quite a nice run. And he now retires as well, so we're down to... Oh, it's Lucas, by the way. He's out, he's crashed as well, and I believe he doesn't have a front wheel. And he retires as well, so, dramas here. Big crash. And did you see what actually happened there? Did you catch that one, Quinn?
Yes, I caught that. Baldessari got it. I think he did a similar thing to Golding quite earlier on, who just ran it out wide at turn 5 and then just got it out too far. Got onto the grass and then the car just spun around to the opposite wall very quickly. You can re-catch it and then smash into the wall. He bounced across the other side and then collected Lucas.
Oh, so terrible stuff there. Unfortunately, wrong place, wrong time for Lucas, but it does eliminate them. That means a T4, one retirement, and also FSR now. So at least one of each now left in this one, which is a real shame, because, I mean, Baldessaro was doing quite well, being very consistent and very clean and just keeping on going. But now he's out. This does, by the way, help Theorix and Nikos at the back. They're 12th and 13th for Hinz Motorsport and Everest. They're lapped down, and they're just sort of circulating at their own pace, but this accident really helps now, as that promotes them into 10th and 11th now, so... as I said, you know, if you just keep going, and even if you get the back, you just keep going, just keep on track, you can gain a lot of spots just from people crashing. That's happening right now, so down to 11 people now out of 18 starters. So, as we said, the attrition rate, we're right on the 50% mark now, so we're at halfway, and we've lost, I believe that is, 7 people so far. So not far off half the field is already retired, so very, very high attrition rate here at the first round of the championship. Actually, we have a bit of battle going on here. It's actually Sirkev and Varkasi. This is 4-6. Sirkev is on the super soft, and that'd be why he's caught him. He's early in the stint, so he'll have grip. Of course, that'll wear away at the end of the stint as the tyre goes off. But he's looking to the inside on him. Oh, geez, got good. Oh, good run. Flicks it out. Nearly contact there, but they managed to avoid it. Sirkev goes down the inside. Oh, no. He's gone off wide. Oh, no. He's going to. Oh, and he's gone in the wall. And wheels off. Big crash at turn one. I reckon that might be race over for Tamás. Real shame. Louis going to try and keep going. As we know with our factor, though, when you pit with a wheel off, it is sort of a lottery on whether the game decides to repair it or not, or whether the crew can repair it. So, big crash in the turn one, and I think, what do you think happened there? I think he just touched the grass and off he went.
Yeah, I think coming into turn one, he just got a bit too over to the left, and then left front was on the grass, so he just didn't have the brake in the grip to slow the car down, so ultimately he went into the wall straight on at turn one.
Indeed, he's crawling around, which is quite weird to see a three-wheel car crawling around the track. Hopefully everyone will be aware and they'll avoid him, but he's going to try and keep going, which is credit to him. He'll try and get around and repair, but as I said, it's sort of a 50-50 on whether they'll be able to repair that, because sometimes it's too much damage and they won't be able to repair it, but he'll try at least, so credit to him for trying. So he'll try and get around and see if he can get that repair, but he'll drop a long way down. That'll be quite a long repair time if he can get it repaired. So it's a real shame for FSR. It looked like a pretty good result. I mean, they weren't really up to the pace of the sort of top five, but they were in good positions for good points, and things have just come undone there. So real shame for them, but such is the way of racing, I guess. This helps Sam Howe, by the way. He's now back up to fourth after the spin at the start. So he's really come back for the field, but it is a long gap up to Vansis there, who's for BRM third, about 13 seconds. But Howie's got a lot of pace, so if anyone's going to catch him, I think he will.
Yeah, Sam Howe, he's won this Melbourne Grand Prix four times before, so from season two until season five, I believe. So you might call him the Melbourne Master.
Fitting name. So yeah, he's got the pace, of course. Unfortunately, I don't think he's going to catch Sandeep. Sandeep's just way too fast and consistent at this point to really be caught at all. I mean, Theos is keeping him sort of at range. He's keeping it about 15 seconds. He's managed to sort of bring the pace back equal with Sandeep. They're both doing mid to high, sort of 29s. Although Theodore is actually doing sort of more low 30s recently, but pretty similar pace, or not far off it. So he's keeping him sort of interested, but it is quite a large gap. I mean, Sandeep nearly got a whole pit stop now on Theodorus. So it's a real shame. We could have hoped for a good battle there, but unfortunately not to be. And then, of course, as I said, you've got Vansis could have kind of on his own in third, in his own little world there. So the Mitsalis is sitting in fifth. And I wonder if he's got. Hang on, let me just have a look here. Okay, no, looks fine. I thought we had maybe some suspension damage. I thought he was crabbing a bit, but I think I was just seeing things. As Sirkev, by the way, has gotten past Sommel. There, I believe that was a move. Oh, no, sorry, no, he was battling with FSR. That's right, sorry, my mistake. He's in pit lane, so he has limped it back around, but it doesn't look like the tyre's on. So he may not be able to get that repaired. We'll keep an eye on that, but it will be, as I said, if he can get it repaired, it'll be a really long pit stop. We'll keep an eye on that. And oh no, there you go, the wheel is back on. So he managed to repair that. So there you go, the limping around has worked, but he has dropped a long way down. He's two laps now off the pace, and he's still waiting in pit lane, so it's a long stop, that one, to get the repair done. Yeah, Sandeep 15.7 now, so he's slowly opening, but it's not galloping away, but it's just been slowly opening pretty much the entire race. So Sandeep pretty much dominating here so far for Adonis. So differing fortunes, really. I mean, he's dominated this entire race, and Broad Meadow, of course, having those technical difficulties, not enabling him to race, which is a real shame, but such is the way of things. As Mitsalis is in. Well, actually, that's what we'll do. A quick run through of who's left here while we've got a period of quiet. So Sandeep Chota at the moment is leading. He's been leading all race, pretty much a dominating performance so far. I mean, Sam was a bit of a threat at the start, but he's just dominated really since then. Hasn't looked back. It's 15.8 at the moment. Back to Theodorus, although that is now 16.2. So yeah, just gained a whole bunch of time in the middle sector. Theodorus, is there a glow? Is in second. Four, I believe that is. Damn, I don't know who it is. Autosport Racing, I believe it is. They're in second. I think he's the only one. Yeah, he's the only survivor because Gostrell Pieri retired the very first lap off the start. So he's the sole surviving one in the team in second, having a good race. And you've got Stelios Vansis for BRM. He's in third. And then Sam Howell is in fourth, catching up to Stelios at quite a rate. He's 7 seconds behind now. That was about 12 or 13 only a few laps ago. So closing at quite the rate. Then fifth is Tony Mitsalis for BRM. And you've got Callan Sirkov battling with Andrew Sommel, by the way, there. That was for sixth. So I think he's defending from Sommel here. We'll just keep you watch this battle before we go back to the field. Sommel going around the outside. Let's see who's going to break later. They break pretty much at the same time. Ooh, a bit of contact, but they managed to get through it. It was good stuff for them to get through that corner. Ooh, nearly, but they managed to get through again. Very close to contact, but Sommel makes the move. He's now up to sixth now. Gets past Sirkov there. Good stuff for him. He's in the reserve car, by the way, so he's not actually racing for a team here. He's just in the reserve car. He's eligible to race, but he doesn't have a team he's racing for now, so just doing the reserve car. Racing pretty much for his own, for himself, really, and doing very well there at 6th. Got a decent pace, doing well. Sirkov is in 7th for GBR, so doing pretty well there, and his teammate Eric Stanford is for GBR in 8th. Again, pretty much his own little world there. We've got Mark Therox for Hins Motorsport there, just filling in. Both the main drivers of that team unable to race. There were two drivers. Dogger, I believe, was the other one who was meant to drive, but he seemed to have some kind of an issue which enabled him not able to race, which is a shame. But he's in 9th now. There you go, actually inside the top 10. So great stuff there for Therox, who, again, as I said, doesn't have the pace, but he's going to keep on going, which is the same for Nikos and Anas. Anastopoulos there, who's for Everest GP, is in 10th, running at top 10. Although he is catching, by the way, Theric, so I've been noticing he's been catching as the race has been going on, so there might be a little battle that can kick off for 9th as the thing has gone. And then Tomas Agassi is the last remaining rider. He's in 11th, 2 laps down after that damage, but he's continuing on, so we'll keep an eye on him for the remainder of this race. And you've got, I believe it is, how many retirements? I said 7, I think it was, yes, 7 retirements. All within the first half of the race, so quite a high attrition rate here, but it's not really surprising, is it, considering there's Melbourne. So, yes, things, as I said, a bit quiet at the moment. We've kind of all settled down, everyone all spaced out doing their own thing, so. Not a lot of battleship. I will say, though, Theodorus has actually just caught up to Sandeep a bit. It's down to 14 seconds, so I don't know if Sandeep made a mistake. Okay, yeah, the lap before last was only a 31.5, so a slow lap that lap around, so I'm guessing that maybe he had a little off or something, although he did a fast lap of the race the next lap round, so just to really prove the point. What did he do this lap? He does a 29.4, so not consistent there the next lap. Interesting stuff here. Interesting start to the season. A lot of accidents and a bit of chaos, which I guess is to be expected. But yeah, interesting stuff, I must say. But hello, is Stelios Vansis just pitting now from third on the medium? So we'll see what he does. I believe he went medium. So we'll see if he goes back onto it again. Yep, medium again. So actually he's going to go triple medium and then probably finish on the option of the super soft. So a short super soft to finish. So yeah, that's an interesting different strategy. We thought you'd do double super soft maybe, but I guess that's just me. I'm just thinking the different way, although that would possibly be a problem with tire wear, so it's fair enough.
Well, they don't actually have to run both compounds here. They can choose to do a full race on the mediums as Stelios has. So he's done it pretty much a proper two-stop to the letter, coming lap 12 and now lap 24, I believe. So he's got it bang on the nail for a two-stop.
Yeah, well, there you go. Yeah, so sorry, I thought we had to do each set. That was my bad, but Don't have to do both sets like in a real F1. So you can just run entirely medium race if you want to, as Sandy chose just pitting out from the lead, which should put Theodorus into the lead. Yep, he should just take the lead by about a second or two. So he'll take the lead back again as Sandeep pits. I believe I did see somebody else in pit lane. I'm just trying to pick who that was. Oh, yeah, that was Nikos there for Everest in 10th. He just pitted from a lap down. Now two. So interesting. Oh, hello. As I've just looked over Tamás in FSR. He's just crashed again. Coming to the S's. He's lost a wheel again. It's the right front this time, not the left front. He's going to limp around once more and try and get that fixed. So I think a bit of a disaster start here, FSR, after looking pretty promising. One retirement and the other one is struggling around. Oh, he's spun off. The gravel trap. Just going in a bit too deep there as he's trying to limp around. And he's still going, though. Credit to him. I mean, not many people would still go after three wheels are left on the wagon, but he's still going. So credit to him for that.
You got to say, the FSR team have got to have a lot of suspension parts for him.
Yeah, they have gone through a lot, haven't they? There was none left at this rate. Quite amazing stuff. As I'm just looking at things, Sergeyev must have just pitted because he's come out just in front of his teammate Eric Stanford, down in 7th and 8th. Somehow back on the podium as well, by the way, with Stelios pitting, but of course that'll change when Sam does his stop, which should be any time now, because he's got a similar-ish sort of strategy to the leaders having pitted earlier on with that damage. So Theodore is staying out, by the way. So he's staying out a bit longer here. Maybe he's going to stretch that medium out, see if he can gain some time, maybe shorten the stops. We'll just keep an eye on Tamás. He's spun in pit lane, by the way. He's just spun the entrance in pit lane down 11th. But he's pitting again. We'll see if they can fix that tyre once more. That car is a battered FS1 car, I must say. Both the front suspension's gone, but he's continuing on. So what I think I might do, seeing as we've got this period of quiet, as also Mitsalis is pitting from 5th now, I'll just quickly see what he does before I do what I was planning. I'll just see what he does here. He's on the super soft, so probably go medium. He's going to stick on the super soft. Okay, alright, well there you go. As because he's just ahead of him, Tamás has actually managed to get the tyre put back on once more, so he will be able to continue on, albeit 3 laps down, so pretty much out of the running. As the GBR teammates are just having a bit of a battle here as they go around the rocks there. So they're having their little battle now for 7th. One of them's on the super soft, one's on the medium, so obviously Stanford's got some pace here for GBR. We should see if there's any sort of tactics here, because they obviously don't want to take each other out. That would be a bit awkward for teammates to take each other out. So, presumably, maybe he'll let him go. No, he's going defensive. Alright, so they're going to fight, or is he letting him go? No, they're fighting. Alright, so they're having a good battle, so credit to him. But, Sergeyev holding for the moment. That's your closest battle in the field. These two GBR guys going at it. Sergeyev holding. He's on the median, though, as I said, so presumably, if Stanford has the grip left, he should be quicker. Sergeyev's pulling away there, so there you go. But, as I was thinking, just while I've got this low period, this quiet period, although there is a battle now for the lead, as Theodorus has been caught by Sandeep, who is on the quicker tyre here, on the new medium, so he will be quicker, obviously, and he might make the move down to the right-hander here. I think he's right up behind him, he'll probably go defensive, but honestly, he'll probably just go around the outside, really, he's got that much grip. He's going to let him go deep and do the up and under there, look at that textbook stuff there from Sandeep. Fantastic move from Chota, he gets back the lead now, he's now got a whole stop on the rest of the field, which is quite something, I must say. But what I was thinking was, we'll just wait for him to go around. I reckon we'll do the lap, we'll do the lap on board. I do like doing laps on board, if you guys haven't noticed yet, but we'll do a lap on board with Sandeep Chota. Just after the stop, do a lap on board with him. Let you listen to the noise and the beast cars on board. Amazing track, really. I'm certainly very good with one. It's just coming to the final point now. I'll let you guys enjoy the sounds of these cars as you go down the lap of this album. Zen 28s now after putting on a fresh set of boots. So looking very, very nice indeed. Theodorus still going long. He hasn't pitted yet, so he's really stretching out those mediums. Maybe he's going to try putting on the super softs potentially to the end, or he might even try and stretch them all the way, which is quite a tactic if you can make that work. What do you reckon? Do you reckon he could try and... Is there a chance he could stretch him to the end from here?
Judging by his pace last year, I think he was quite aggressive on his tyres last year, so I think he will probably be pitting in the next couple of laps for a set of super softs and putting some qualifying laps pretty much to the end.
Yeah, indeed, Rachel, I'll have to agree. It would be a very, very long stint if he can manage that. I think he pitted about lap 13 thereabouts. I think it was a lap after Sandy. So they've gone on for, that's about, what is that, a 17-lap stint. That's quite a long stint, those mediums. So he has stretched them out, even if he is hard on the tyres. He has managed to stretch these quite a lot. He's losing bucket loads of time to Sandeep, though, now, as he just doesn't have the grip that Sandeep has on new boots. You'd assume he'll probably come in this lap, because he's even getting caught by the lap traffic there, so he'll probably come in now. No, he's still going on. Is there some kind of strategy here? Because I would assume that you'd probably be able to stretch out the super softs by now, but apparently he doesn't think he can, so he's continuing on. He's actually under pressure from the lap car, who's managed to catch up to him, the Everest GP car. And he's actually pressuring him for making a move, which of course he won't be able to make because he's a lap down. So that's interesting to see. Swing through a field. Yeah, and look at that. There you go. That car goes around the outside of the Everest GP. Moving past the second placeman. That's how much pace he's losing right now. He's just having to be pace on those worn tyres. Continuing on. So is, I don't know, is there some kind of a hidden strategy here that we're not aware of, do you think?
I think with that lap car going past him, that would have been a message to him to get back to the pits and put a new set of shoes on the car.
Yeah, indeed. I mean, look at his Stanford again. He's also lapped down. He's now just unlapped himself, I think, from Theodorus there. That's how bad the tyre wear is. He's just, these tyres are gone. In fact, he's probably going to lose second to Sam at this point. That's how far he's dropping down. It's about 20 seconds. That's roughly a pit stop. It's going to keep getting a bit worse as he goes around. So I reckon he's going to lose a second even. So he'll drop the third, I reckon, in the stops. Because he just can't keep stretching these out. If they're losing that much time, you cannot keep stretching them. Because he's just going to end up probably spinning off. And in the end, they'll just completely fall off the cliff. So surely he's going to pit this lap. Let's have a look. Surely he's going to peel in. And yes, finally pits. It was holding out for a long time. He'll go on the super soft, so he will be pacey, but I do think that Sam's probably going to jump him in the pit lane, or at least he'll be very close, which is interesting to see. He did have a clear gap in second, but that's not the case anymore. Sam, of course, is very fast around here, probably equal really to Sandeep's pace, as Theodorus, as we said, puts on the super soft, and he will pretty much come out with Sam. So I'm actually wrong, he's managed to beat him out, but only just. Look at this, Sam's going to be right behind him as he exits. He'll have the exit to possibly challenge down into the next corner. He won't have DRS, of course, because he wasn't within a second at the detection zone. But there will be the slipstream effect. Will he have a look? Oh, has a look to the inside, but no, isn't break late enough. So Theodorus holds on, and this is probably going to be a battle ready to the end, this battle for second place. But an interesting good drive from Sam, by the way. What are your thoughts on that? Nice little drive after the spin at the start.
He's shown his experience with those four wins here at Melbourne, so he can drive this track excellently. So he's brought it back through. He pitted quite early on, and he's only lost 32 seconds to Sandeep over the entire race distance, so that's pretty impressive.
Indeed, he's just having a look at Theodorus now down to the S's. I was going to say, if he has a go down there, that's very brave stuff, but he doesn't go for it, so Theodorus holds on for the moment. But Sam's all over him, so you'd assume he's going to make a move somewhere soon. You know he's got the pace, but you also know Theodorus has the pace. Obviously, qualifying third, was only, I think, 3/10 off Sam's time. So they've both got the same sort of pace, so this should be a really fascinating battle at the end. So 87% in the last sort of run here for this race, last sort of sprint to the end. We've got about 7 laps or so to go. So we're nearly at the end now of this race in this latter stage, and we've got this cracker of a battle for second here to keep us interested. As just noticed Oak Stanford is out thanks for an accident apparently, so there we go. GBR's run ruined a bit there, so that just leaves Sergeev now. But we'll keep an eye on this battle as Howe going down the inside. He has DRS and he makes the move stick with the help of DRS there down into that corner. We'll see if he can stretch away now. I think he does have slightly better outline pace, but Vettel is much slower, for sure. So there you go, that's down to the time, I believe is 7th. And Sirkev now alone with GBR, he's in 7th, but again, this helps the lap guys, once again. It's going to help them out now. Etherix, by the way, I think has lost 9th to Nikos at some point. I'm not sure when that was. Oh, hello, I just noticed, yeah, Etherix has actually got damage. He's crabbing really badly. So he's got quite a lot of damage there to that car. He's obviously had an off somewhere. But he does have 2 laps in the rears of Tamás there in the FSR car. So he's got some time to the car behind. Oh yeah, that is really badly crabbing. So he's going to have to limp that back around. Which is a real shame for him. He was having a really consistent run. But he'll still be in the top 10. So it'll still be a good result. He'll actually be 9th after he passes Eric from his retirement. So that is, I think, is that 8? So yeah, we're about pretty much one off half the field retiring. So unbelievable attrition right here. But Sam back under pressure. Theodorus has a look. Ooh, down to turn 1. That was a bit of an interesting move. A bit late. I was going to say it's a bit of a brave move if you're going to go that late down to turn 1. Should have DRS. He's not really catching though, and yeah, can't make the move. So Sam holding on. As I said, Theodorus is pretty much bang on pace-wise with Sam. So if anyone's going to challenge, he will. But look at the gap to Sandy now. 30 seconds. This really has been a dominating performance from him, hasn't it?
Exactly. But let's be fair, he showed us this at the first preseason race in Bahrain. He came back of the field. In fact, he opted to start from the back of the field and then came through to win the Grand Prix for the remaining 20 seconds. So I'm surprised that he's only got a 30 second margin here, considering he started from pole, but it's still a dominant performance and something we're probably going to have to get used to for this year.
Yeah, indeed. Now, just know Throx is actually retired, unfortunately, so he's also retired. Probably thanks to that damage, or he may have even gone off again trying to limp it back round. So, unfortunately, it's another retirement. So, we have pretty much literally half the field is retired here. Only 9 survivors. So, unbelievable attrition rate. It's a shame also for Hens Motorsport. That means one that couldn't start and the other one is retired. So, 0 points for the first round. A really quite awful start to the season for that team. But, I mean, what can you do? Unfortunately, that's the way it works in racing. Doesn't always go your way. But Sam's still under pressure here for second. From Theodorus. He's probably looking defensive. A little bit, tries to defend, but Theodorus goes down the inside. A little bit of contact, but good move from Theodorus. Sam there thought he saw it coming, went to defend, but Theodorus just stuck it down the inside. LeMay's intentions clear, and he's now back through in second place. There's a good battle here in these closing stages. We've only got a few laps to go. Everyone else is quite spread apart, although Mitsalis and Summel are close to fifth now. And also about there, back there. Have a look at that. Oh no, she's going to Sam's now down inside. Oh, his contact is round. Oh, so drama here. Another spin for him. More contact. Looks like he just went for the inside down there into the corner and just, round the outside, I think it was. And just a little bit of contact and round he went. So, real shame there, but he's still going to be third. So, he hasn't lost out in terms of positions. It doesn't look like he's got any major damage, but still, there goes his potential second place. So unless Theodorus makes a mistake, which I don't think he will, that's probably going to be his finishing position now. But yeah, that's interesting. What do you think make of that? I think Racing Incident, personally, but what do you make of that one?
I think it's on the edge of, because somehow had his front wing almost level, I think. So we're riding on board, so we'll have to have a look later. He's almost level, and then Theo just came across from the outside and shut the door on him at the apex. So I'd call it a racing incident, honestly, but depends on how you look at it. Some people may see it as a major incident.
Yeah, indeed, I'll have to agree. Definitely a little bit, potentially close one. I mean, it looked very close, but I would say, yeah, Racing Incident, personally as well, but, But yeah, in the end, you know, it's happened. It's racing. It does happen. Accidents do happen. You can't really avoid them. But he now drops to third. Oh, sorry. Yeah, was in third. Drops to third and drops back behind Theodorus. He's got about 7 seconds. So you assume that will probably be his finishing position. As Choda, I believe, going across to start the final lap, if I'm not mistaken. So final lap of the race here. And Sandeep Chowdhury honestly just absolutely dominated this race. I mean, it really hasn't been much of a competition. As, by the way, Sumble made that move on Mitsalis. He's now moved up to fifth. Which, again, as I said, he's not actually racing for a team. That's a spare car. He's using the FS1 spare car. So it's not actually a team car. He's up in fifth. So, you know, if that's a message to any team managers, I don't know what is. But, hello, Sirkiv there, just going around in front of him. Oh, hello. Ooh, Mitsalis doing well to dodge that. He had to dodge right as Sirkiv's trying to flick it round. By the way, we had another retirement. Tamas there in the FSR car. The remaining FSR car had to retire. Clearly, he had another accident or the damages too much. So, unfortunately, it's a double retirement for FSR as well. So, a couple of teams having really quite... not having the starts they wanted for this season. But that's the way of racing. So, eight left. It's eight survivors out of 19 starters, so an unbelievable attrition rate here at the first round of Season 8 of this series here in SimLeague.de. Is Sandeep Chowdhury has really just dominated this race. We haven't seen him much just because he's been dominating the entire race. We haven't really had much to show. Really, it's just been him at the front having an absolute ball of the time for Adonis. So, really a perfect start to the season for him. He's coming around the final corner now. It's been a perfect race for him. He's pretty much not put a foot wrong all race long. He's going to take the win here at round one of season eight. Look at that, weaving the wheel in celebration as he crosses the line now. Takes the win here at Melbourne. Fantastic drive for him. Really just a perfect drive for Sandeep. So credit to him. He really did nothing wrong at all in terms of mistakes and anything like that. Theodorus, though, he's going to come home in second. So good stuff for him. Good start of the season for that team. Again, as I said, Joel Pierre, the teammate, didn't finish. But still, good stuff for him. Second place. Sam Howe for T4 is going to be third. Good stuff for him. Good start. As I said, good comeback, by the way, considering the spin he spun at the start of the race, dropped way back to about 10th or 11th, and he came through for third. So good stuff for him to recover for a podium. Who is next? Then we've got Stelios Vansis for BRM. He's in fourth. Good stuff for him. Good result. Good start for BRM. Sumwell gets fifth. He was actually catching Stelios at a good rate. So another few laps, and he may be able to catch up to him, but there you go. Tony Mitsalis again for BRM 6. So in terms of constructors, I think BRM will actually be the leaders in the Constructors' Championship potentially here, because I think they're the only team that had both their guys finished, so there you go. Anyway, Callan Sirkiv for GBR, he takes 7th, so good start for them. Again, they were, I think, an Amarin run team, so good stuff for GBR, good start. And then, of course, Nikos Anastasopoulos. Ranzo Ifield, he's an 8th for Everest GP, 2 laps down, but he finishes the race and gets valuable points for that team. And then we have, I believe I said, 9 retirements this race. So over half the field retired, so unbelievable attrition rate here. And of course, as I said, we had a few that couldn't start with connection issues, which is unfortunate, but unbelievable here, the attrition rate in this race. So there you go. That's the end of the first round here of FS1. Very good drive from Sandeep, as I said, pretty much a dominating performance completely in his own league. But I know for me personally, I think personally the surprise and the real standout performance is BRM, because they should, if they don't lead the constructors, they'll be very close to it because they both finished. So there you go.
I believe Adonis will be leading the constructors with Sandeep's 25 points, but BRM are close. With their double points finish, I think they're on 20 points.
But that's probably that one.
The combination of Stelios and Mitsalis last season, they scored the same number of points, their team, as Sandeep's team. So I think possibly if the Greek... what were we going to say? If the Greek duo can work together well and get their pace up, they could possibly challenge Adonis for the constructors this year.
Yeah, indeed, I agree. They're definitely a threat. I mean, I think we pointed out, I think it was mentioned in the preseason, we were we were talking, I know on the forums there was talk of who would be a surprise package, who would be ones to look out for. And honestly, BRM, I do agree, are ones to look out for. A shame though, one that I found interesting was Insignia. I mean, we saw them at Bahrain, they showed so much potential. And unfortunately, both of their drivers retired here. So another team that had double retirements, so another one that has a bit of a bad start. But I wouldn't be surprised if they come back later in the season, because we know they have the pace. I mean, Owen showed it in qualifying, and Booker's definitely no slouch either. So they've got the pace, but hopefully they've just got to try and finish the next races, because they could really be a threat later in the championship. But there you go. There's the race. 8 finishes. So, yeah, as I said, unbelievable attrition rate, although it was quite an interesting race. As I said, there was a few points there. It quietened down. There was not many battles going on, but there was always those strategies playing. As I said, you know, you had Theodorus doing that. It's a different strategy to the guys around him. It didn't really end up working, but still, you know, a good win to Sandeep. It was only 15 seconds at the end. I think Sandeep really quite majorly backed off at the end of that race. Lots of these times. Yeah, he was back down to the 30s in the last few laps, so he really backed off big time at the end, which is fair enough. He had like a 30-second lead, so it's not like he had to keep the pace going. So, but yeah, there you go. Quite an amazing race here, I thought, considering things. Wasn't a lot of on-track battles for quite large periods, but there was always a strategy play, I thought, and some big crashes too, as we saw. I mean, the broadcast would record a few of them. There was some big, big crashes throughout the race, but I guess we'll go for final thoughts. So any final thoughts from you, Clinton?
Other than impressed by Sandeep keeping his pace up over the winter, he's going to be challenging for the championship once again. Sam Howe's impressive drive after his spin down at turn 3 on lap 1. I believe he put his middle stint. He pitted on lap 3 and then pitted on lap 28 or something. So he made a huge... Those medium tyres go a long way, I think. So impressed by him. Theo as well. He's put in a good performance. Took second place here. So if he can find that additional pace, he could be up there as well, challenging for the Drivers' Championship this year.
And Deacon, you know, I have to agree with those points, really, I'll be honest. Yeah, Sam definitely a threat. He has the pace, as I said. He just had that contact, I believe, with Owen Golding down into turn 3 on the first lap. I'm interested to see if anything comes of that. Any penalties. I don't think anything will, of course, because Golding ended up retiring, so he kind of got the ultimate penalty in the end for that. But if there was any fault involved, but... Yeah, I agree. Sam is definitely a threat. I mean, he had the pace. He just had that early spin, which really cost him quite massively. So he's definitely going to be a threat, I think. You know, Sandeep, I don't know if Sandeep will walk away with this. He did walk away a bit with it today, but, I mean, people had their issues, so he didn't really have threats of, say, you know, Owen Golding, for example, or even Summel show good pace, or Sam, to really have big threats thanks to them having little issues. So, you know, you've got to keep that in mind. You've got to keep that in mind. And things change for later rounds. People get quicker. People have, you know, certain tracks they're better at. You've got to keep that in mind later on. But, yeah, I agree, Sam, big threat. Some good results from BRM. They really had a great start to this championship for them. So, fantastic stuff from their perspective. They probably couldn't be happier with that start. I know I would be extremely happy with that kind of start to the season. And yeah, it's really, and a couple of teams having double retirements, so bad starts for them. You know, Hins Motorsport, Insignia, FSR, not particularly great starts for them, but it's all season long for them to catch up, and we'll try and be here for all of that here at Simrace TV. So, hope you guys enjoyed. That's really about it for this round one of FS1. We'll be back again for round two, I believe it's at Malaysia, in a couple of weeks' time. And I hope you guys are here to watch that one as well. We certainly enjoyed doing the broadcast here. First official one for SimLeague.ie in this FS1 series. So I hope you guys enjoyed. On behalf of myself, Thomas Hins, and Quinton Plain on the cameras and co-commentary, we will see you for the next round at Malaysia. So see you then.